Strike me, how'd you get the cat to sit on the cup?
It's that bloody Nola and her stupid tricks. But she won't do it again because I gave her what for.
Well, what happened?
I asked her for my money back.
And she did?
Of course she did. Stupid bitch. Stuffing tea bags with that rotten muck. But I fixed her.
Well, it's certainly not tea, that's for sure.
It was absolutely ghastly, Inspector. I quite thought she was going to kill me.
Detective Sergeant Brent, ma'am. Not Inspector, unfortunately. How long was Smith in your employ?
Oh, nearly 2 weeks.
And you never suspected her before?
Well, of course not. One doesn't expect to find a murderer under one's roof.
Now, goodbye, Sally Connor. Hello, Kath Willis.
Lizzie tells me she sold you back the tea bags.
So?
Gonna drink them? Or you gonna smoke them?
What's it to you?
I know what's in them. We don't get dope in here. B sees to that.
B's not around here anymore.
Yeah, I know. I know you too. And I know you didn't get him in here just for yourself.
Of course not. There's plenty to go around, so long as the price is right. You can spread the word for me if you like. Nola McKenzie's back in business again.
Yeah, for a while. You were lucky getting it in. Won't be long before the screws are onto you.
Don't you believe that, kiddo. Not unless there's a lagger around here. And you know what happens to laggers, don't you? No, I'm back in business for keeps. This is only a start. I'll soon have lots. I'll have acid, grass, speed, anything the women can afford to pay for. Interested?
You mean she's got real grass?
Here? That's right. It's only the beginning. She reckons she can get a speed, acid, anything we want, as long as she gets her price.
Go on, I reckon that Nola's only trying to make herself look big. I don't reckon she's got any Mary Joanna at all.
Sorry, Lizzie, but I saw it myself. And I reckon by the time she's cut it with some smokes, she'll have about 30 joints.
How'd she get it in without the screws spotting it?
Ah, she's got a real tricky lurk. She got a mate of hers to bring her in some eats. And a very unusual box of tea bags.
Tea bags? Well, I'll be buggered. I thought that was the worst cuppa I'd ever had.
Well, Lizzie, you're not supposed to put in milk and two sugars. Instead of one for the pot, it was pot for everyone.
You wouldn't be so cocksure if B was here. She'd toss that muck in the garbage where it belongs.
What's she got against a bit of harmless grass anyhow?
She didn't like dope of any kind. She'd go off her head if she knew what that Nola was up to.
Yeah, well, she doesn't know, so we don't have to worry. Anyway, she'd only spoil things by harping on about it.
So would you if you'd lost your kid the way B did.
Yeah, it's tough, Lizzie. But that was years ago. Anyway, B's not here, and I reckon we all know how to handle ourselves. So, who's for a bit of instant happiness, girls?
Know anything, and I think you're just wasting your time.
Well, circumstances have changed since then, Miss Burns. We now know that...
Oh, this is Debbie. Debbie Phillips. She's my flatmate. This is Sergeant,
Detective Sergeant Brent, Miss Phillips. Detective Constable Rawlings.
Hello.
We didn't have the opportunity of meeting our last visit.
Last visit? Doreen?
Oh, well, I was going to tell you. See, one of my mates, B. Smith, well, she's escaped from Wentworth and, well, she had a postcard from me with our address on it.
Oh, she what? How on earth could you be so stupid?
Well, she's my mate.
And, Sergeant, you think this woman might show up here?
We think it's a possibility.
Oh, but that's absurd.
That's what I've been trying to tell him too. Bee's real smart, you know. She would have figured out that the police would be sniffing around me, so she's probably hundreds of miles away.
That's not very likely, Miss Burns. We have positive identification. Smith is here, in Sydney.
Oh, gee.
Well, she's not in my flat, Sergeant, and I can assure you she won't be.
Look, all we're asking from Miss Burns is that she contact us if Smith ever gets in touch with her.
But...
it's for Smith's own good. The longer she stays on the run, the more chance there is of someone being hurt.
Don't worry, Sergeant. If Smith shows up, I shall personally call you.
Well, I think that's all then.
I'll show you out.
That's all right. We'll see yourselves out. Thank you both for your cooperation.
Don't mention it. You might at least have told me.
Anything?
Nah. I'm pretty certain Burns hasn't made contact. Not yet, anyway. Her flatmate wasn't very happy about being kept in the dark.
Well, do you want to keep me on it?
Oh, yeah. At least until we get some other lead.
Well, like I told you, there's been no in or out of there except the two of them.
Yeah. Sue Crowley's trailing the Burns girl. Apparently she hasn't set a foot wrong.
Well, maybe she's onto us. I mean, she's been inside. She knows the score. She could be playing us along.
No, I don't think so. She's not that bright. We'll just have to wait. Sooner or later, Smith will turn up.
You'd better learn to knock unless you want your face rearranged.
Sorry. Auntie Maxie said you got some grass here?
That's right. You got the bread?
Sure. How much?
$2 a joint.
Great. Give me two.
Don't be greedy. One at a time.
But I got $4.
No buts about it. I'm running this store. You can have one. And smoke it after lockup. If those screws smell any grass around here, they'll tear this place apart. And some of them might even want a cut. If you do the right thing, you can have another one tomorrow. That is, if you've still got the bread.
Look, just one more now. What difference does it make? I'll be careful.
You're not listening to me, Dobson. No need to flood the market when you've got a monopoly. Is there?
Well, how long are you going to stay mad? I said I'm sorry.
I am not mad, Doreen. I just don't want the police popping in and out of here at all hours. I mean, after all, it's my flat.
Well, it's mine too. I pay half the rent.
Oh, which reminds me. The rent's due Monday. I think we ought to settle it before I go to the coast.
But you're only going away for 3 days.
Half the rent, that's $350. $300 for the month for groceries and electricity, and your share of that's $200.
But that's not half.
I've told you before, Doreen, you can't expect me to pay half when I hardly ever eat here. I mean, look at this week. You can sit at home and stuff yourself while I'm away working.
Some work. Going to Surfers Paradise for 3 days with some smart convention.
Now, let's see. That's $5.50 you owe me. Look, best we get it cleaned up before I go, don't you think?
You won't be able to bank it till you get back anyhow.
Just the same, I'd like to have it. Just don't know what problems might occur in the next few days. Thanks.
That bloke's been out there all day. Do you reckon he's a cop?
So what if he is? I've got nothing to hide. And I told that sergeant that you didn't either, remember?
Yeah, okay.
Well, see you in a few days. Oh, and don't leave the lights burning unless you need them. Electricity costs a fortune. See you.
See ya. $550 bloody.
N12 to VKG. Subject number 2 has left the building and is driving away in a green Gemini. Registration number KOE 452. Request a unit to Taylor.
Kings on nines. I reckon that's my jackpot.
Hey, Lizzie, lend us a few bucks, will you? I'm flat.
What do you mean, flat? I've already lent you $2 tonight.
Yeah, well, give us four and I'll owe you six.
Bite your bum. If you haven't got the cash, then you shouldn't bet. Anyway, what do you want money at this time of night for?
Well, I want to buy a couple of joints and Nola's charging $2 apiece.
Go on. I wouldn't lend you money for that rotten weed even if I was Rockefeller.
Smells like real good stuff, Max.
Yeah, it is. Hi, Lainey, you and...
I'm cleaned out.
And here is the news update.
Die!
Another crash in Europe.
Hey, Die, got any money left over? I'll pay you back real soon.
All right, if it's that important to you. Only I want it back.
Yeah, straight away. $4 if you can spare it and I'll share a joint with you.
No, thanks. I don't use it myself.
Neither would she if she had any sense. Well, I don't know what's the matter with you young people these days. You'll try anything new. What a bottle of bloody scotch you'd do me.
Smith has been traced to Sydney, where she was hired as a...
Hey! You're talking about me!
...soldier employer, leaving her bound and gagged before escaping with an undetermined amount of money. Police are anxious for anyone who may have seen her to contact them immediately. Smith is considered extremely dangerous and should be approached with caution. That's the news for now. We'll see you now with the news update.
Oh, love, I hope you know what you're doing.
Having trouble staying awake, Thompson?
No, Sarge. But this job's about as exciting as watching paint dry. Burns hasn't budged. Nobody's been in or out since the Phillips girl left.
Yeah, car 23 trailed her to the airport. Right now she's winging her way to the Gold Coast.
Huh, lucky girl. Kind of beats this, wouldn't you say?
Yeah. It's only another hour, Michael's to take over. And see who's on again in the morning. Keep at it.
Right.
Born in a tent, Daniels.
They're yours?
The door. Close it behind you.
Oh, sorry. I wanted to get you before lock-up. Give us a couple of joints, will you?
Well, just make sure you smoke it in private and don't let the screws get a whiff of it.
Well, don't worry. I'm not stupid.
Oh, are you kidding? $2.
Yeah, but I wanted two.
No way. I've got to ration my supply.
Oh, come on. It's not for me. It's for Lizzie. She asked me to get her one. Oh, please, come on. She'll be really crooked on me if I leave it out.
Okay, just keep it under wraps. You know, that pal's got a nose like a ferret.
Yeah, and a head to match. Tart.
Daniels.
Where have you been?
Pal's been after you.
Wait till you see what I got.
Come on, you two, get in.
Righto, Mrs. Powell.
Night, Mrs. Powell. Hope your dreams are as sweet as ours. Hey, Lizzie, I've got a present for you.
Well, if it's any of that Maori Joanna, I don't want her. The smell of it turns me stomach.
Oh, but Lizzie, I've got it special for you. It cost me $2.
God, Maxie, I don't know how you can pollute yourself with that muck at your age.
I'll cut it out. Do you want it or don't you?
No.
Well, suit yourself.
Oh, good, disgusting.
Don't you think you should see a doctor about that?
Rubbish. Is only a cold?
Well, suppose you know best.
I didn't know you cared. By the way, see the police have got a lead on Smith?
About her being in Sydney? Yeah, I heard.
I thought she'd turn up in a place like that. It's perfect. Easy to get lost in.
She really gets to you, doesn't she?
She made a fool of me. And nobody does that and gets away with it. She'll learn that the hard way when she gets back in here.
Well, of course, they've got to catch her first. And if I know Smith, that won't be easy.
They'll catch her all right. Then she'll find out that she's just a common thug and not the high and mighty queen bee that she thinks she is. She'll learn that the hard way.
Gesundheit.
G'day, Laney. How's it going?
Terrible. What do you reckon? Can you still see him?
Well, it's no good asking me, because I already know they're there. But I don't reckon no stranger would take much notice. Where'd you get all the makeup from?
Well, Judy lent me some, and Guy lent me the rest. Only the stuff doesn't really work.
Well, don't worry about it. It's only a job interview.
Yeah, I know. Oh, but suppose I do get this job. I can't spend the rest of my life slapping makeup all over me.
Well, you won't have to. Look, all you gotta do is get them to hire you first. Then once they see that you can do the job real good and you get a few mates, well, no one's gonna give a stuff about a few tattoos, are they?
Yeah, suppose.
Yeah. Well, cheer up then. God, I thought you'd feel like $1 million after that joint we smoked last night. Ripper stuff, wasn't it?
Yeah, I reckon.
See? You almost smiled in spite of yourself. Come on, let's eat.
Good, Maxie, I don't know how you could eat all that after smoking that rotten weed all night.
Gives you an appetite, Lizzie. Now you eat up, Laney, because you've got a big day today. You need lots of energy. Jude's organised an interview for her, Lizzie.
Yeah. Good on you, love. I'll keep me fingers crossed for you.
Thanks, Lizzie. But I reckon I'm going to need more than that. I'm real scared of interviews.
You'll be right. We'll all be thinking of you.
Thanks. I know. But I wish Alan was going to be with me.
Well, he'll be thinking of you too. You know he's wrapping you.
Yeah? Well, how come he hasn't written to me since he got out?
Now, you just listen to me. I've been around long enough to know a good thing when I see one, so you've no need to worry about that young fella. You'll be hearing from him real soon.
Yeah, I reckon you're right, Lizzie.
Of course I'm right. Now, you eat that up, because he'd get really mad at you if he knew you were mooning around.
All right.
You certainly took your time, McKenzie. I reckon the service is better once the rush is over, Mrs. Powell.
Hey, bird brain, enjoy your smoke. You know, it's funny, I thought an old bugger like you would be more at home eating grass, not smoking it.
You think you're very smart, don't you? But I'm a wake up to you.
Leave it, Lizzie. She's only trying to stir you up.
Must have a different effect on old buggers like you. Oh, well, can't please them all, I suppose.
Those silly buggers have got more money than sense. That Nola's gonna take over around here before anybody knows what's happening.
$17 to VKG. The suspect has left the house and is heading down towards the ferry. We'll follow on foot.
Hi. Looks like we're going the same way, doesn't it?
Yes, it does, doesn't it?
Yeah, well, maybe we should tag along together. Makes the trip go faster, eh? After all, it's going to be a real long day for you just hanging around watching me all the time. I'll tell you what, there's a coffee lounge just across from the shop. You wait in there and I'll pick you up after work. It'll be much easier on your feet.
God, it's hot in here.
Yeah. Gonna be a stinker today.
Oh no. Look at me hands. All my makeup's coming off.
Oh, well, don't panic. It's only the steam. You can fix it up later before you go. Here.
I've got a little number that'll cheer you up.
Oh, no, thanks. I'm going to do this interview. I want to have me wits about me.
Fair enough. God, Maxie, isn't it bad enough at night without stinking this joint out when we're all trying to work? And supposing the screws smell it?
Ah, no worries, Lizzie. I'll just smoke it out the air vent. The screws won't smell a thing. See? There's no flies on me.
There's no need to ask how you are. It's obvious. I'm surprised you're here at all.
Don't worry. I've decided to take your advice and see a doctor. I made an appointment at lunchtime, but I might be a bit late getting back.
Why come back? Perhaps you should be home in bed.
No way. The day I let a cold get the better of me is the day I hang my uniform up. And what's on the agenda first thing this morning?
All right. Collect Dobson from the laundry.
Right.
She's got to get ready for a job interview. Bryant will be around to collect her about 10.
No sooner said than done.
Ooh, what's that? You change your brand?
Yeah. Same old faithfuls, why?
The funny smell.
Smell?
Yes, it smells... Doesn't matter.
I can't smell a damn thing with this lousy cold.
Whether you can smell it too.
Yeah, it's all through the staff room. Look, I know it sounds stupid, but to me it smells...
Cannabis. Yes, I know. It's so overpowering my office, I had to open a window.
Your office as well?
Hmm.
Well, that means there can only be one place it's coming from, the ventilating system. I'll round up a few offices and start an immediate...
No, just not yet. There's something we have to discuss in private.
Hey, Jacko. Airbag giving us a push. Now I better steal. You are better. We'll all have a ride.
Beauty! Oh, God, Lizzie, what are we going to do?
Oh, God, I'm buggered if I know. You keep knitting hollow if you see any screws.
Good on you, Lizzie!
You'll have every screw in the joint in here in a minute, you silly little twit.
Hey, Lizzie, you got your teeth in today? Or you written them out?
Cheeky little bugger, I'll give you teeth. Oh, God, what are we going to do?
It's going to take her hours to come down, Lizzie.
You freak. Here, quickly, Maxie, come here. Hi, behind me.
Hi.
Hold yourself together. I'll laugh, everybody. Oh, how did you come to get my mind?
What the hell's this racket all about?
Oh, Miss Ferguson, wait to hear this. It'll bring my tears dear.
Save it, Birdsworth! I said save it! Dobson, get outside, you want it. The rest of you, cut the cackle and get on with your work.
Marry Joanna.
I've been expecting something like this ever since we received Jill Clark's report.
But surely that's all the more reason why we should search immediately and catch the women off guard.
Not if there is the slightest chance an officer is involved and could alert the women.
Joan Ferguson.
Officially, I can't use names at this stage, but if this officer is involved, it might be wiser to stage the search without her knowledge.
Meaning while she's off duty?
Precisely. And if we handle this the right way, we might just get the evidence we need to rid Wentworth of her once and for all.
Look, just sign out, Dobson. I haven't got time to stand around here all day while you pussyfoot about.
Look, Lainey is very nervous about this interview.
Oh, not surprised. She probably realises she's wasting your time. I don't know why you bother.
It is my job, Miss Ferguson.
Ah, yes. Your job.
Well, I suppose I'm ready. How are you feeling?
Like 50,000 butterflies are skydiving in my stomach?
Come on, it's not going to be that bad. Let's go.
Just a minute, Bryant. Forgotten something. You haven't signed out.
Oh, yes, I have, Miss Ferguson. I'd do anything to make your job a little easier. Come on, honey.
Well, at least if we check the register, we can...
Oh, Miss Ferguson.
Morning, Governor.
Mrs. Powell tells me that you're not feeling very well. You should have taken the day off.
Oh, I appreciate your concern, Governor, but I think I'll survive till lunchtime and then I'll let the doctor decide.
Whatever you think best.
Yes, well, I have some work to do, so if you'll excuse me.
Certainly. Well?
McKenzie received a parcel yesterday.
And the officer who checked it in?
Ferguson.
Please, try to relax, Miss Dobson. I promise you, I won't bite you.
I'm sorry. It's just that I was supposed to see Mr. Fredericks.
Tom Fredericks. Yeah, he's down with this rotten virus. But I prefer to see my girls personally anyway. Now, let me see. You're interested in becoming a cutter, is that correct?
Yeah, I guess so. Look, I just want a job, sir. But I'm sorry, I've got no experience.
Oh, my dear girl, don't apologise. We've all got to start somewhere. And you can't get experience if no one will give you a job, now can you?
No, I suppose not. Judy Bryant says you train people.
Oh, and so we do. But experience isn't all that important, as long as you've got the aptitude and you get on with the other girls. We're one big family here, you know, Lenny.
Sounds just great.
Yeah, and you don't have to worry about the training. Jenny, our chief cutter, she made an awful mess of things when she first came here, but we stuck with her. I felt that she would come good, and so she did. Now, you look like a young lady who would be prepared to work hard.
Oh, I will, sir. I just need a chance, that's all.
Yeah, well, let's get rid of the red tape, shall we? This is just a formality. Your name, address, experience... Yes, well, of course, I wouldn't be able to give you an answer straight away. We've got a lot of girls to see, and it wouldn't really be fair to make a decision without seeing them first, now, would it? How about if you give me a call in about a week or 2 weeks? No, better still, how about if I ring you when we've made a decision? I think that would be the best idea, don't you?
Fredericks is off sick. Saw a man called Coots instead. Nice old bloke. Wanted to make me part of his big, happy family. Till he saw me stinking tattoos.
That's bad luck, honey.
Am I going to have to go through this for the rest of my life, Judy? Because if I am, I'd rather die.
Now, hang about here. Look, why don't you and I go somewhere and sit down, talk this through, huh?
Oh, what about Davidson? I've got to get back.
Well, what Davidson doesn't know isn't going to hurt her. And if you're a good girl, even buy you lunch, huh? Okay?
Come on. Phew, doesn't look as though I'm missing much.
Oh, thought you would have gone by now.
No, I'm just on my way. Have you had any luck with your funny smell yet?
No.
Probably just the incinerators. Well, I'll see you in an hour or so.
What was all that about?
I'm surprised you didn't smell it on your rounds. Someone's got dope in here. It's coming through the air ducts, but we don't know which section of the prison it's coming from.
What? Why haven't we done a cell search?
We think Ferguson might be smuggling it in for the women, or at least turning a blind eye. That's why we've waited until she's off duty.
Nothing would surprise me.
Oh, you know, I'm not sure this is worth breaking my diet for.
Oh, good. Then it makes it easier for me to tell you you haven't got time to eat it.
What?
Sorry, but we've got to conduct an immediate cell search. You two round up the women, will you? I'll collect the officers.
You're not missing a thing.
Strange time of day for a cell search, dear. Do we know what we're looking for? Well, you feeling better now?
Yeah. Oh, well. I reckon I'm always going to be a freak, so I better learn to live with it. You must reckon I'm a pretty hopeless case.
Not at all. I just wish there was something more I could do for you. I mean, how'd you get in this mess in the first place?
Tattoos.
Hmm.
I don't know. You know what it's like when you're young. I was 14 and in a home.
God, Judy. Some of them girls could give Wentworth a run for its money. Always causing trouble. Mostly out of boredom, though. I don't know what it's like. Almost go crazy with nothing to do. Anyhow, tattoos were all the rage. We used to nick needles from sewing baskets. We'd use anything we could find. Indian ink, mascara, anything. Everyone was doing it.
Yeah, well, you could have said no.
Are you kidding? One girl did and they made her life hell. They reckoned she was chicken. No way. Anyway, I got me first one done. Didn't think much of it. But, you know, after about me third one, I guess I sort of became proud of them. I wanted to have more than anyone else. God, how could I have been so bloody silly?
Well, there must be something we can do. I mean, have you thought of plastic surgery?
Yeah, I've tried. Scars are worse than the tattoos. It's no use. Either way, I can't win. But it's worse knowing it's my own bloody stupid fault.
There's nothing in there.
Look, come on, you lot.
No idea.
There's plenty of stuff coming. The sooner all of this will be over.
What about our tacker, Mrs. Powell? The bell's already gone.
It's okay.
Nothing. Why don't you tell us what you're looking for? Then we could all lend you a hand.
Yeah. Shut up.
Yeah, maybe we should draw you some men.
What's up with Maxine?
You ought to know.
Yeah?
You gave her the bloody stuff.
Yeah?
Ryan, you told me the joint was for Lizzie.
Well, it's not my fault she didn't want to swipe it.
So you couldn't wait, eh? It's all your fault they're ripping the cells apart. I thought I could smell dope when I was cleaning the corridors, but I didn't think anybody could be that bloody stupid.
Well, I tried to get rid of
it. Save it. I don't want to know. You should think yourself lucky that I've got that stuff stashed away in a safe place where the screws can't find it. But you'd better be hoping that they don't find the stuff or get onto my little racket, because you're going to be history.
Martin, there's only 20 minutes before the work bell.
Oh, God, Mrs. M, I was looking forward to seconds. I'm bloody starving.
All right, Lizzie, but don't give yourself indigestion.
Well, I've got to keep my strength up.
You reckon they give us a proper lunch break? Wasn't our fault we were late. Probably cheesed off because they didn't find anything.
Yeah, but they could have. That stupid little bitch Daniels could have cruel to pitch for everyone if they'd caught us stoned.
Yeah, but they didn't.
Yeah, well, I'm not taking any more chances. Either they do it my way or they can go jump. I'll keep the grass to myself. Got it?
Sure, Nola.
I'll move it, McKenzie.
Yeah.
Now, where have you been, Daniels?
Well, I had to go to the toot, Mrs. M. Didn't have time after work.
Well, hurry up.
Hey, Babs. I'm starving. Is that all?
Yeah. Nola's threatened to cut up our supply of dope because of you. You want more? Go see her.
Oh, gee, Lizzie. I reckon everyone's real crooked on me.
Well, what do you expect?
Why didn't you smoke it in your cell like Nola said? She didn't just say it for fun.
Yeah, there's one thing having dope around, but another flashing it around every minute of the night and day. And it's not just you who gets into trouble, it's all of us. No wonder everybody's bloody crook on you.
Yeah, I know. I just didn't think, that's all.
Yeah, that is your trouble. You never do.
And you made a thorough search of the recreation area as well?
Yes. And we didn't find a thing.
Well, do you think Ferguson had time to warn McKenzie or perhaps pass a message to one of the other women?
Oh, no. I doubt that. Well, even if she had, McKenzie wouldn't have had time to hide anything. We collected her straight from work for the search.
Mm. Well, there's always the possibility that McKenzie is not involved.
She is the most likely candidate to be running a drug racket. And she received that parcel. Obviously, she just found herself a very good hiding place, which we haven't uncovered yet. Well, Mrs. Davidson, we know she's been trading with the women in the past. I would say she's got plenty of stock stashed away and that the dope is with that.
Which brings us right back to where we started. Well, we'll have to find it. Otherwise, McKenzie is going to get overconfident and start importing drugs of a much more serious nature.
Yeah, it's got me worried as well.
You know, it's ironic. But for all her faults, when Smith was here, at least there was some control over the drug problem.
True.
Well, how did it go?
Terrific.
Come on, Dobson, I'll take you through.
What on earth happened? I thought it was all settled.
Well, it was, but Fredericks was sick and she had to deal with a guy that I'd never even met.
Oh, dear. And he wasn't impressed?
He's impressed with Lainey, sure, but not with her tattoos.
It really amazes me how easily people are influenced by something like this.
Yeah, I know, and it's what's inside that counts. I mean, that poor kid will never get a job unless she can get rid of them.
Well, that's more easily said than done. She's so many of them.
Well, there must be something. Mrs. Davidson in?
Yes, but she's with Mrs. Powell at the moment.
That's okay. I'll wait.
Perhaps you'd like to try this one. It's not silk, but it is the colour you wanted.
Miss Burns, could you spare a moment, please?
Oh, there's a fitting room over there. I'll be with you in a moment.
Thank you.
Yes, Mrs. Dennis.
Doreen, this is Deirdre Macon. She's joining us as a sales girl.
Sales girl? Oh, well, you're going to have an easy life. We're not exactly run off our feet.
When the sales begin, we'll need all the staff we can get.
Whatever you think. Nice to meet you, Deirdre.
Yeah, same here, Doreen. I'll come to you if I need a hand.
Oh, sure. Well, I better get back to my customer. Well, how was that?
No good. It was a bit big.
Oh, never mind.
Just arrived. There's been no sighting of the subject yet. No, not Burns, Smith. If she's going to show, it'll probably be during the lunch hour rush. Yes, will do.
Well, I do appreciate the problem, Judy, but I don't quite see how the department fits into all this.
Look, Mrs. Davidson, we've always been told that the department are more interested in rehabilitation than in punishment, right?
Yes.
Well, there are dozens of girls, just like Lenny Dobson, who would love to be rehabilitated, but they haven't got a hope in hell because the tattooing has scarred them mentally and physically.
I agree with you, Judy, but I do think it's unreasonable to expect the department to foot the bill for the removing of the tattoos. After all, it is not their responsibility.
But that's just my point. It is their responsibility. If you take Lenny Dobson as an example, okay, she fell victim to tattooing while she was in an institution. Now, the department may not have condoned that, but they sure as hell did nothing to prevent it. Now, if Lainey hadn't been in that institution, she might not have been pressured into having those tattoos, and she wouldn't have the problems she has today. I mean, morally, at least, the department must take some responsibility.
You know, Judy, I think you've missed your vocation. You really would have made an excellent saleswoman.
Well, do you agree?
Well, how could I resist after you putting forward such a convincing argument? I'll speak to Mr. Douglas and tell him your views, but perhaps not quite so eloquently.
Well, do you think they'll do something about it?
I said I'd speak to him, Judy, but after that it is in his hands. Quite frankly, I'm not very hopeful of our being successful.
Yeah, I know what you mean. There's no harm in trying, is there?
Oh, hello. How are you feeling?
Not too bad. If I take all the pills the doctor's given me, I'll rattle when I walk.
Well, I'm certainly very glad to see you. Would you hold the fork while I dash out of the kitchen and grab a sandwich? I am starving.
Well, so soon after lunch?
Well, that's just the point. With this cell search that Colleen organised through the lunch hour, there wasn't time to eat. I wouldn't have minded if there'd been any point to it, but there
cell
wasn't.
Search?
Yes. Apparently there's grass in the prison, or so Mrs. Davidson thinks. She and Colleen smelled it this morning, but we didn't find anything. You know, I don't know why they didn't search for it when they first detected it instead of giving the women time to hide the stuff.
No, neither do I.
Oh, as if we haven't got enough to do. At least they could have done it while you were still here. Give us an extra pair of hands. Oh, I don't understand their logic.
No, nor do I.
I want to talk to you, McKenzie.
What?
Right, where is it?
I don't know what you're on about.
You've got dope in here. And the governor and Powell know about it. And what's more, they think I'm in on it. So I want a little bit of compensation.
You're out of your tree.
$50, Mackenzie.
I reckon you're running a fever, Miss Ferguson.
Don't push me, Mackenzie. Now, I don't know how you got that stuff in here or where or when. And I don't want to know either. But it's only a matter of time before you get caught. So you're going to have to trade that off pretty damn fast if I let you.
You? You've got no stake in this one.
Oh, haven't I? If I'm going to run the risk of taking the rap for you, I want my cut of the take, and I want it now. Because I can hound you right out of business if you don't do what I say.
Okay, I'll think about it.
Think fast.
Get rid of.
Oh, geez, you sure made a mess.
I don't care.
Oh, look, I know how you feel. Well, sometimes I wonder why I did it, especially when I'm trying to impress some bloke and he turns off at the sight of them.
Yeah, but at least you're not covered in them.
Yeah, but I knew a girl like you. But she was stupid. She tried to cut him out with a razor blade.
A razor blade?
Now, don't you go getting any ideas, because she was stupid, and all she did was ended up looking like chopped meat.
Well, there's got to be some way I can get him off. Acid might get rid of him.
Yeah, and half your arm with it. Look, Lainey, I don't know what you can use. They keep everything under lock and key anyway. They certainly don't leave acid lying around.
Caustic soda. They'd have that in the kitchen.
Forget it. Oh, please, Lainey, don't go messing with that. It's bloody dangerous.
I don't care. I just want him off me arm. Hey, Babs, any screws around?
No.
They clear off pretty quick when there's work to be done.
What about in the kitchen?
Barry's in there stuffing her face with sandwiches. What's it to you, anyhow?
I was wondering if you could nick me something.
Yeah? Like what?
Like, caustic soda.
What the hell do you want that for?
Never mind that. You reckon you can get past Barry?
Barry's too busy feeding her face to notice anything. Of course, it won't be easy. It's kept locked up, you know. I reckon I could get it. For a price.
That's all I got.
It's exactly the price I had in mind.
She's real desperate, Lizzie. And I reckon she could do something real stupid if we don't watch her.
Well, I'm not watching her. I've got better things to do with me time. That's the trouble with you young ones. You do crazy things and then you expect us old ones to bail you out.
Lizzie, don't you care about her?
Of course I care, but there's nothing I can do, so I'm not going to make myself sick worrying about it.
Yeah, I suppose so.
Hey, Daniels, you've really done a good day's work, haven't you? First you get us a cell search. Then we miss half our lunch break. And now we've got the screws breathing down our necks. What are you going to give us tomorrow? Leprosy?
Fair go. I said I'm sorry.
Well, tell it to your mates. If there's no more joints, they'll know who to blame. Now listen to me, everyone. I can make life a whole lot easier for you. I can get you grass, pills, maybe even coke. Booze too, if that's your bag. Only I've got to know that you're with me and that you're going to do it my way. Well, what do you reckon?
Thank you.
What do you reckon, then?
Oh, I think I'll like it. Mrs. Dennis seems okay. And the work's easy enough. Certainly makes a change, anyway.
Oh, you haven't done this before, then?
Well, not for a while. I've been working in a supermarket, demonstrating makeup, that sort of stuff.
They move you around, don't they?
Pardon?
Still, all these jobs will come in handy if they ever decide to make you an undercover cop, eh?
Sorry, don't understand.
No, of course you wouldn't. Gotta go, I've got a customer waiting. Excuse me, madam, can I help you?
Oh, I don't know. What do you reckon?
Hey.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too. When morning comes around.